Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you 10 ways you could find the full path to any file on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, one of the most common questions people ask online about Macs is how to find the path to a file. I'm going to show you not one, but more than 10 ways to find the file path. So here in the Finder, you can select any file you want and then use File and then Get Info or Command I. This will bring up the Info window, and in there you could see the path. You can even select it, and if you use Command C to copy and then go to a document, I have a text edit document open here, you can paste it in. It'll paste in the path name. So as you can see, this is a more literal path as the computer sees it, whereas this one is a little more human readable, including the name of the hard drive and putting little triangles between each folder. Now there's an alternative to the info window, and that's the inspector. So you could go to File and Get Info, but before you select it, hold the Option key down and it changes to Show Inspector. The shortcut is simply Option Command I. This brings out what looks like the same window, but this is actually a floating window that will stay on top and change depending on what's selected. So if I select another file, it will stay on top and show me the path to that file, which in this case is the same thing. But if, for instance, you went to Recents, then you could select different files in here and see the different paths to each one. Now in the Finder, it's very easy to actually see the path of the folder that you're looking at, and that's by using the path bar. If you don't have it turned on already, go to View and then Show Path Bar or Option Command P. Then at the bottom here, you'll see the path. You can actually copy this as well. Select what level you want to copy. So I'll go all the way down here to Local Documents. Control click on it and I could copy that as a path name, and you can see I get that path. So I could also just copy from this level and I get just that path. And if I select a file, it gives me the full path to that file as well. The great thing about this is it works in search results too. So if I do a search for all files that match a name and I get the results here, I can select the file and I can see the path to it, which is very useful when you're looking through a bunch of results and you want to find the one that matches but it's in a certain folder. Now another way to see the path for the current folder you're looking at is to command click on the name at the top here. If you do so, you get a full list all the way back to the hard drive level, and you can select one of these to jump to that level. If you'd rather not have to hit command for that, you can go to View, Customize Toolbar, and then add the path button, and then the path button does the same thing, but it's just a simple click. Now if you select a file and then you use Edit Copy or Command C and then you go to paste it into a text document, you'll just get the name of the file. But instead, if you notice, if you go to Edit and where it says Copy, if you hold the Option key down, it says Copy as Path Name. So Option Command C will do that, and then you could paste in the path to that file. But you can also do this with a simple drag and drop. So I can take a file, drag and drop it to a text document like this, and it will put not the file, of course, in there, but the path to the file. Now if you open a file, at the top you've got the title, and just like with the Finder, you can command click it and get the full path and jump to any level that you want in there. So using one of these with folders in it will actually open up a new Finder window pointed to that folder. Now often when people are asking how to get the path to a file, the reason they want it is because they want to use it in the terminal. And there are some easy ways to get the path of a file and have it instantly appear in the terminal. One of those is simply drag and drop. So for instance, if I wanted to see the contents of a simple file in the terminal, I could use the cat command and I could drag and drop the file into the terminal window, and it will place it wherever the text cursor was. So you can see here it placed the full path, including a backslash before the spaces, which is really handy because we often forget to type that. Now you can also use copy and paste for this. But instead of having to Option Command C to copy the path, just a regular Command C will work. So if I select a file like this one, Command C, and then go to Terminal and Command V to paste, it will paste in the path. Well, what about searching for a file in Spotlight? A lot of times when you search for a file, you don't necessarily want to go to the file, you just want to see where it is. So let's do a search, and I'll just search for a simple name like this, and I'll get some documents as a result. And then I can select a document and I'll get a preview here on the right. Still no path though, but if you hold the Command key down, the path will appear down here. In addition, any file you have selected, of course, you can click on it again and it will open it up. But using Command R with the file selected will actually open up a Finder window and select that file. So here are some bonus advanced ways to do it. Let's say you wanted to make a quick keyboard shortcut that will give you the file path for anything selected in the Finder. You can build that in Automator. So let's run Automator here. I'm going to create a new document and make it a quick action. Then I'm going to add into it set variable, because what's going to happen here is this workflow will receive, and I'm going to set it to files or folders in the Finder. So I'm going to take the input of this, which would be a selected file, set it to a variable. So I'm going to create a variable called file path. And now I need to do something with it. First, let's have it display as a notification. So I'll put it down here. No title, no subtitle. Just here I'm going to drag file path to it. If you don't see this window here, you can click there to bring up the variables. So now I'll display it as a notification. And in addition to that, let's copy it to the clipboard. So I'll just put copy to clipboard right underneath this. So it'll display a notification with the path, copy it to the clipboard. Perfect. Let's save, and I'll call this get file path. So in the folder here, I'll control click on this file. I'll go to quick actions, get file path, and you can see it quickly displayed the notification there. It does it really quickly the first time for some reason, but it'll take longer after that. Let's go now to System Preferences, and under Keyboard, Shortcuts, since we've run this once, it should appear under Services here, under Files and Folders, Get File Path, there it is. Let's add a shortcut. Let me do Control Option Command P for Path, and we could see it added that. So now if we use that shortcut, we could see it appears there a little bit longer, and then also we could go in and paste the results there. So there's that file there. Let's go to this one, and there's the path for that one. I can dismiss it and paste that in. So now you've got a handy little shortcut. So there are more than 10 ways to find the path for a file that you see in the Finder or perhaps have opened already. And hopefully one of these will work for any situation that you come across. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.